We will be start discussing the chapter from gathering to growing food. So you know now that at the Paleolithic age, people, they were hunter and gatherer. They don't know how to grow food, so they used to collect from the nature whatever it is available, or otherwise they used to hunt animals and get their food, meat, or they used to take forcefully, they used to get their eggs or milk like that. But they have not learned the procedure to domesticate them. Nowadays, if you want some food, what is the easiest way? We get our food from any of the markets available. And from in the market, from where we get all these vegetables, fruits or grains, because people know how to grow them from the village, in the village areas, by our agriculture, we are getting all those things available. At the same time, we domesticated so many animals now, and whatever we need some eggs, so the poultry and the poultry farms are there to supply them. We need milk, the huge dairy farms are there, those who are supplying us the milk. So all these animals are domesticated now, and we human, we are using them for our own purpose. So getting food is not that tough as it was when they started it. So how they started? First of all, we know there was a huge climatic change. So different type of food, that also depends that where you are located. In the hilly areas, the hilly region, the type of cattle available for rearing or for what we can see there, that is not the same as in the plain areas. Like sheep, goats, they can survive easily in the hilly areas, but it will be difficult, little difficult for the other type of cattle what we can find in the plain areas. So when there was a huge climatic change after Ice Age, almost 12,000 years ago, from that time, due to the change, people started farming and herding. Now what are these all? We will be discussing that. The climate, as the climate of the world changed, men, women or the children, they must have noticed the type of plants, the type of cereals that was available before is now changing. It is much more available due to the favorable condition of the climate or nature. So then they started protecting those cereals from outer attack, like from the birds or from other animals who are destroying those crops. They started protecting them, and they started then getting from the nature itself. Now they even observed that this is the way, natural way, what is a natural way to get cereals or fruits or other things. So they observed that some of the food grains, they might fall down on the field, and from there another sapling or another plant grown up. So they tried themselves and they started growing their own. Though it was not that easy, it has taken a long time, it is a longer time period game. It was not that one day they observed and from the very next day they started growing it. It was not that easy. But anyway, they continuous observation, continuous looking at the plants, that how it changing, how from a little sapling it is now growing as a plant and then giving them the fruits or the whatever the cereals or grains that they can eat. By checking that, they started, that thought of domesticating those plants or planting their own cereals, their own fruit, their fruit plants, that idea came, maybe that idea came to human mind. Another thing was helped them a lot. You know about the Stone Age. This was the story, the fact we are discussing about, that is a time of, that was a time of entirely Stone Age. Due to the invention of microlithic stone weapons, now it was easier for them to dig the earth or plant anything inside the earth. It was not that they are just throwing on the ground and most of the grains are just ruined and they are not getting any plant from them. they started, they observed that by digging the earth, if they put those cereals down and the grains down, and then they are pouring some water in that, maybe from there they are getting good type of whatever the plants they are looking for. So that also helped them to get that agriculture, the first agriculture done, and to get their food from the nature, other than the natural way how nature is providing them the food. Next we are coming to the hunterer from the domesticator, herderer, domesticated animals. So what they did, some first they know that they started hunting wild animals, just they need the meat. Now the types of food they experienced, then they started feeling that if they can domesticate all these animals, then they can get their food whenever they want it. So they started domesticating animals. Do you know what is the, who is the first domesticated animal? Yes, it is our pet dog that was domesticated almost 12,000 years back. And from that time, dog is your best friend. Other than what dog used to do, how dog was domesticated. They were domesticated just to help a human being for hunting. Human not yet then started domesticating other animal or growing plants. So dog was just domesticated just to help them in hunting, maybe to scare other wild animals by means of getting some food, whatever their children or their women they used to give them. Or another two animals which also domesticated in the first region of domestication, they are sheep and goat. Sheep and goat actually provide them at the same time milk as well as their skin used you can say the cloth at that point of time, and for meat. So these animals always used as a storing room of food for human being. People knew that point of time that if these animals are with them, then they can get food whenever they need it. They can kill those animals and they can get their food, or continuous supply of milk. They started domesticated those animals. Those are easy to domesticate, easy to tame, other than the wild animals. Naturally, the animals, those who are wild in nature, it was tough to tame them. They were not able to control their temper. Rather, these wild animals can damage them, can kill them, or can cause any kind of damage in their tribe. So they started domesticate rather soft nature animals who can be tamed easily, sometimes by giving them food a little forcefully, sometimes even allowing them to be with them in the same village, same area. That's the way they started domesticated all these animals. Now, domestication is the name which is name of a process that the human being used to get animals in their tribe, wherever they are living in their areas. Now, it is a process. It is not the very first day these animals were domesticated. But when they, even these animals, they saw that they are getting continuous food supply, they need not to search for it. And they are with their nature also, they started obeying human being. Very often, plants and animals that tended tamed by the animal, by the people, they were very selective, like which plant or which animal can be the best way to get their food. It was nothing else but just to get their regular food supply. So domestication process was started by the mean of getting regular food supply from nature, other than depending on the nature always. Rather, they are selecting a part of the nature for their own purpose and they are using them. I told you those who are very gentle, they were domesticated first. We can find that these animals, though those who were domesticated, they also faced many physiological changes. As a wild animal like tiger, even now you can see the teeth. It is very fierce in nature. Even they can cut and eat meat. That's the way, raw meat, that is the way they are made. But at the time of the domesticated pet dog, you can feel that they are very soft, and they also have many physiological changes, that they are not that fierce of nature, not that wild nature as it was before. Even the wild boar and a domesticated cow, you can see the difference between these animals, those who are were domesticated. Domestication is a gradual process. It was started almost 12,000 years back, you know, I told you, with the domestication of dog. And even now people are in that process to domesticate some of the animals which we even now we think that they should not be domesticated. They are the nature, they are wild in nature. The first plant which human domesticated, which people started, the first cereals, they were wheat and barley, because of the production. The places mostly in Indian side, we can see that Asia Indian side, that in area, Iran area, Iran Bolan Pass area, we can see, we found that Indus Valley civilization, we found that number of wheats and barley, mostly that was the first domesticated plant which people use for their food. Some of the earliest domesticated animals were dog, sheep and goat. So these three we have discussed. We discussed about types of food, we discussed about what is farming and herding, and then we discussed the process of domestication, how they domesticated plants and animals. Now this is the time when people started settle down in a form of a group, the first village, when people they know that they have the enough food supply, what they need for a particular time period. So a group of people, they settled down in a place. You can say that that was the first village. And these people, as they know, then as you know now, that they domesticated some of the plants also, they domesticated some of the animals for their food purpose and their safety or protection purpose. So they cannot carry their land and the herd of animal with them going from one place to another. Till the time a particular fertile land is providing food for them, they were very much confined in that place. They cannot move with a piece of land. So they were settled down there. That was the first village, we can say. And that was their a new way of life. No more searching food in the morning, rather growing food. That was a change human being experienced. No more for hunting animals, rather taming animals and getting food, continuous food supply from them. These animals, we call them as storing animals, means these animals become their storehouse. Whenever they need milk, they need eggs, they need flesh, they utilize these animals. So they became the food storing house of storing animals. They became the food storing house of the human being, the modern human being. Changes naturally when they settle down, different type of in the life we can experience in their life, we experience different type of changes. It was not only one man and one man and he's a little one or two or maybe 10 people together and they are only gathering in a place. It is more than that. Many people, they started staying together, first in a form of a social system. And whatever the sites we find there, those who are giving us the evidences, that these people, the first farmers or the first herders, how was their life? We find many different things in the different areas depending on the region. Whatever the who all are the taming animals or the type of their food, that was also different from northeast to southwest. So people, they started settling down many places depending on the food supply or the fertile land or the continuous water supply. They started settling down. They started naming them as tribes and they started growing more food. We don't know exactly who is the first farmer, which place is the they started farming first. But as per carbon dating test, some of the places, the evidences we find that can give us that proof that man started settling down in Indian region long back. What are the remains we get? It can be the burning part of the cereals that changed to charcoals these days, and the bones of the animals and the way we got the bones, how it increased. The checking them, as I told you earlier, that historians sometimes act as a detective. As a detective, the archaeologists, they act as a detective. And by getting all these archaeological evidences, they came into a resolution that these people, they settle down, they know all these things, that how to grow these type of like wheat, barley and other food grains, and as well as how to tame these animals, and that was the part of their life. And there was no difference in their working, you know, they used to work together. It was not that someone work and someone utilize them. It was not like that. Rather, the entire village or community member, they used to work. There was no division of land, like this is my land and whatever the fruit and or the cereals I will grow here, I will get from here. It was not like that. Rather, it was a property of the village. People used to work there, and whatever the food they used to get, it was equally divided to all members of the society. It was not the family based society, it was completely a village based society. It was a settled life now. We can call it as a settled life. People are no more moving here and there in search of food. Rather, they started first the search for a fertile land, continuous water supply, the river valley areas where they can settle down, and they can get again and again from the same land, they can get again and again the same quantity and same quality type of cereals. Now they know that how to do agriculture, how to get water from the nearer water bodies, how to get more food grains for them, and how to develop some other social activities also. So they started settling down. Archaeologists, they found that the huts and houses at some of the sites. Here people built pit houses. Pit houses, that was dug in the ground with the steps leading inside the ground, and these may have provided shelter in the cold water, cold weather. Even archaeologists found that most of the village houses, they have cooking facility both the side, either inside of the house and outside there was a place where people used to cook. That give us an idea that maybe these people, they cook together, that's why they wanted to cook outside, or depending on the climate, they decide that where they must cook, either inside of the house or outside of the house. Stone tools also are the evidences what we find in many of the sites, this type of many sites. Stone tools are the main artifacts of this age, what we find there. Depending on the stone tools, we can say that whether the tribe, whoever settled down there, they are mostly depending on agriculture, or they were taming animal, they are the herders, or they are in search of wild animals also hunting. Many different Paleolithic tools, that those also sometimes they have used in Neolithic era, that also we can find. And now the tools are as in the Neolithic age we find the tools are polished, as they are called Microlithic also. So they are polished and they were used in a way to hunt animal, to or to dug the earth to get some good fruits, good plants or trees to grow up. Mortars and pestles also used for grinding. Do you know, I hope you all know that what is grinding. Now the mixer grinder is solving all the purposes. But even now we use the stone grinders, right? To make dosas, and sometimes in some of the houses or grandmas, they are using it. So this is the time when people started grinding cereals to get better taste or some other taste in their food. Usually they are eating, they are using it. So these evidences of these mortars and grind pestles also we find in some of the sites. Even we find some of the tools that were made of animal bones, the hard animal bones that also used to make some tools. Another thing that actually changed the direction of history when we started learning about them, they are earthen pots. The time when the wheels were invented, people started moving from one place to another place easily using wheels. Almost the same times, even the potter's wheels also invented. Do you know what? I hope you all know what is potter's wheel, which potter is using for making earthen pots and all, the clay pots. So these clay pots, the evidences of these clay pots, we find in many sites. They used for cooking. They used for storing foods and whatever they cooked or uncooked food. So for various purposes, they started using the pots. Along with that, so now we can see even different profession. It is not only that all people, they are going for agriculture and they are in the field, or they are going for herding the animal. Other than that, another one occupation we find that some people, they are the potters. They are making clay pots, which other people, they are also using in the same, that was the way these group of people contributing in the society. We even find this time the improvement in the clothes. It was no more only the animal skins they are wearing. They started weaving clothes, and naturally a new art, and that was in demand. Some people, they were occupied in this profession. First time in the history we can see that different type of occupation also comes, where the first people started it as to contribute in the society, because food is for everyone. So people used to divide and have them, but then it started as occupation. Many areas, men and women still continue to live in the same life. Mostly the tribes, they have this type of social system existing. They don't divide individually whatever they are earning or whatever they are getting as food. They give everything in the tribe to the leader of the tribe, and the leader of the tribe distribute it equally to each and every member of the community. What about the customs, rituals? Now, first we need to know that nature was the first god. People started scaring nature because they cannot control nature. So they started worshipping nature because they had no idea why the sun is coming in some time. Then after some time, they cannot get sun. How much they tried for even the when they started controlling fire, even that time they experienced that fire is the thing that is giving them the basic part of their life. Fire is providing them warmth. Fire is providing them, helping them to cook food, to get better taste food and everything. So they started worshipping fire. River is the other way. You can find even now people, they are worshipping rivers. Many rivers they are worshipping, because that was the lifeline of human civilization. Without river water, they cannot survive. So naturally they started worshipping nature. Even some of the rivers which are flooded a particular period of time, they thought like worshipping these rivers, they can control the flood. So they started praying them. They were very much scared of dark while going out. So light, whatever is providing light, whether it is sun or it is moon or it is fire, whatever it is providing light, that they can feel safe. they started worshipping them. This was a common nature of rituals started all over the world. People first started with nature worship. Then all the customs and other practices came. We started that farmers, they started with simple agriculture. They have started, they even started the type of plant, they started observing them. And they, now they know that what is a particular time period of the year they can get, the crops will be ripened and they can get them as their food. So they started praying to do this type of plants or a particular god created in their mind whom they started worshipping to get better food. Many of the farmers, when and the, their groups, when they group together, we call them as tribe. And certain customs and practices, even today, these tribes, they are following. Three generation when they are living together in the settlement or villages, we call them as tribe. And many people, most of the families, they are related to one another. They have some family relation. So naturally, their customs, their religion, their practices, social practices, everything is at the same way. They think the same way. They worship God at the same way. They are called as tribe. And member of this tribe, that a particular tribe, they follow a particular type of occupation because they grew up with that. Their upbringing is like that. And they think, they started thinking in the same way. So they are called as tribes. Women mostly were engaged in agricultural work because women were the one who used to stay back. And men used to go out for hunting purposes or herding purposes, to tame animals or to give them proper food. Men used to get them out to get more food or some other activities, or to protect even the tribe or the villages. Children also, yes, naturally they were not going to school like you, so they also was occupied. They were given to them to look on the small plants or the animals. Those who are tamed, already tamed by them, to give them food or to serve them or to make them clean and all these things. Women also thresh, husk and grind the grain, and men usually led a large herds of animals in search of pastures where these animals can get some green grass or some other food. But all, both men, women and children, they, whenever they get their free time, they used to work to make pots, to make baskets and some other things that they need for their daily livelihood. Now, from here, when the tribes formed, when the people started staying generation after generation together, some people naturally, they came out as leaders. These leaders, actually, they were responsible, they took the major responsibility of dividing the food among the people, those who were settling together, among the people of the tribes. And people, mostly the old experienced people, they were chosen as the leader of the tribe, whom everyone used to obey. You need someone who can take decision and who can whose decision people will follow. First idea of leaders, and the leaders grew up in that, in this period of time. These tribes, they have their rich cultural heritages. They had their languages, they had their own music to sing. Even now you will find that some tribes in India, they have a particular type of dance form, they have a particular type of music form which even today they are practicing. These societies, actually, what is different, that the entire, what make the tribes different, that the entire wealth, whatever who is collecting as a member of a tribe, it is considered as the wealth of the entire tribal group, not any individual property. So that is no doubt a complete different thing. Some of the places in India and outside India we find that these places are, we find out different sites where we can get proofs of whatever we are claiming till now. Without proof, as a detective cannot claim anything. Like that, even archaeologists, even the historians, they cannot claim anything that this happened in the past. As we know that literature or scripts were not developed in this prehistoric age. So people has to depend on the artifacts or the archaeological evidences that are available. So we search in many of the sites, the archaeologists, they search in many of the sites, and from there they got the evidences which support whatever history is claiming now was happened in the prehistoric period. One of this place is Mehrgarh. Mehrgarh is a place that is in Bolan Pass, the way from Iran to India. In Bolan Pass, Mehrgarh is a place. In Mehrgarh, the life, naturally it was a hilly area, but they were the it is suspected that by the carbon dating test that they were the first one, the men and women who learned how to grow wheat and barley. So they domesticated first wheat and barley, these two, the Mehrgarh people. And archaeologists who they found the evidences of many type of animal bones. That also in like step by step, some one step it was less, but as they dug, the number of bones were less. But on the upper layer, they found that a number of animal bones are more, which actually explain that the days as their life improves, they started taming more number of animals, and as a result we can find more animal bones in the upper layer of the earth. The bones of animals we find there, pig and deer are the animals that was the these people, the Mehrgarhian, they started taming them. And these place we find many houses, mostly square or rectangular houses, and this house has mostly four or more compartments. Compartment means which we can call as rooms now. So these rooms, they are used for, some of them they are used for storage. The way they made, that was a storehouse, we can easily detect them, and we found some cereals also from there, which proves that these houses, these rooms were used as a storehouse by this Mehrgarhian people. Now when the people die, that was this was, we can see the beginning of the rituals what even today some of us we are following. When people die, the Mehrgarhian, the friends, they pay respect to them. They feel like these people, those who have died, they have not left them. They are with them. So they wanted to keep their body with them. So most of them, perhaps with the belief that there is a life after their death, they started buried that dead bodies. And they used to pay their homage regularly to the areas where they have buried their dead bodies. The burial arrangement, several burial sites we found there in the Mehrgarh area, that probably meant that they used to offer whenever the time of a new grain, like when they are getting more grains, food grains, or they are getting something very good in their tribe, they used to offer it to the dead bodies also, their dead friends or relatives also, with the belief that there is a life after death, and definitely the death people, those who have died even, they can get this. Are we not following the same thing even today? We are offering something, whenever we get something better, we are offering, we are remembering our relatives, those who are no more in the world. We are following the same rituals which started long back at Mehrgarh. Daujali heading is a site near Brahmaputra Valley. Daujali heading is famous because this is the place where we find many stone tools as well as the pit houses. And these pit houses, actually it's telling us the climate of that place was cold. So the fluctuation of climate help them to hide themselves from the adverse situation in the climate inside the peat house. Many peat houses, they have long stairs down, and people then can get warmth of the earth when they are going down in the earth. They find that many stones that have been brought from China, so found in Dauji Hiding. So Dauji Hiding, we can see that they started some kind of trade relationship with China. So people, they are bringing some things from China to India, this area also. Stone tools, mortars, pestles, many things, even the clay pots, these are the evidences that Dauji Hiding also, they developed in a very good way. Also, the common type of tools and fossils of some fossil woods or some other animals also, they are the same as we found in Mehrgarh and in Dauji Hiding. So, this all things, whatever we have discussed, that proves that life started changing in a major way. It was not the same, and it was the change people experienced every day. Every day there was a change, and that change now heading them towards a settled life that ended to Indus Valley civilization. Now they are civilized. They know how to control food, growing food. They know how to control fire, and they know how to live in a social bound society. Thank you.